good to the last term. It was they give us a fat expression to his most favorite beverage, coffee. I believe that most of you are drinking coffee. If you don't, maybe you know about coffee. Do you know that coffee is the second most valuable legally traded commodity in the world after oil? Yes. It is because coffee is the most favorite beverage with high number of demand of it. According to the National Coffee Association, there are 54% of Americans over 18 drinking coffee in every day. This means there are 100 million people drinking coffee in each day. And US spend around $40 billion in each year just for coffee. Imagine. Once, there was a famed French writer and philosopher named Voltaire. He was rumored that he drank coffee for 40 to 50 cups in a day. Based on that, coffee is a daily ritual in the lives of human civilization since long time ago. Yes, it was an old drinking culture. So, where exactly this caffeinated phenomenon began? As most food that have been around for centuries, coffee beginnings in the lore and mystery. And there was a utopian legend wherein coffee discovered by a goat herder named Caldi. His goat was frolicking and full energy after eating the berries of coffee. And Caldi, he tried and he had the similar reaction, just like his goats. And there were the monk witnessing this phenomenon, the strange phenomenon, and he took some of it and bring it to his fellows. And he spent the night awake and alert, just same like Caldi and his goats. Before coffee became our morning beverage of choice, it appeared in various different of preparation. In its most basic, unprocessed form, coffee is a cherry-like fruit, which has become red when ripe. The coffee bean is found at the center of it. And early on, the berries was mixed with animal fat to create the protein-rich snack bar. The coffee drink that we have today was a bit around 1000 before Christ. At that moment, it was made from the whole coffee fruit. It wasn't until the 13th century that people began to roast the coffee, just like we know it today. That was the first type of the coffee making. The modern version of the roasted coffee originated in Arabia. And during the 13th century, coffee was extremely popular among the Arabic Muslim community for its use for stimulant power, which proved for them during their long prayer session. In the 1616, the Dutch founded the first European owned coffee estate in Sri Lanka and then in Ceylon and in Java in 1696. The French began growing coffee in the Caribbean, followed by the Spanish in Central America and Portuguese in Brazil. European coffee houses sprang in Italy and later on France after that, where there is a new number of popularity. Now it is a de rigueur for Parisians to indulge the coffee with a baguette or croissant with a numerous coffee cafe in Paris. Coffee plants. They reached a new world during the 18th century. Though the drink wasn't really popular in America at the moment until the Boston Tea Party of 1773. When the switch from tea to the coffee became something of a patriotic duty. The Civil War and other conflicts that followed also helped to increase the popularity of coffee. Soldiers was relied on the coffee for the boost of their energy. It may have started a bit later, but Americans love coffee just as much as the work do. And Teddy Roosevelt is counted as America's great coffee drinker due to the rumor He drank a gallon of coffee every day. Imagine. By the late of 1800, coffee had become a worldwide community and entrepreneurs began to gain the profit from it. And in 1864, the Arbuckle brothers, they purchased the first coffee roaster and they began to sell the pre-roasted coffee bean on the paper bag. They named it Ariosa. Later on, there are several names appeared, such as James Fowler, Maxwell House, and Phil's brother. In the 1960s, a certain awareness of our specialty coffee started to grow, and the most inspiring one was the opening of the first Starbucks store in Seattle in 1971. Today, a bunch of coffee movement continues to grow and increase. In it creates a small independent owns coffee, boosting sustainable, locally roasted and fair trade beans. Coffee has become an artistic trait that is valued to its complexity of flavor, just like wine. From a simple cup of black coffee to a complex, multi-complex adjective Starbucks order, each coffee drinker has their own favorite of way to indulge in this caffeinated wonder drink. All in all, coffee has built the human civilization history for a year, and coffee is become a part of culture. As Cassandra Clare, author of City as a Say, as long as there is coffee in the world, how bad things can be. I forget to show the